Hi, my name's Miranda.
And hi, my name is Zoya.
And we're from the National Portrait Gallery Youth Forum.
We're here right now in the National Portrait Gallery about to give a talk about the Van Dyck Transforming Britain exhibition, which is right behind us. Hope you enjoy it.
So if I can take you over to the centrepiece here, which is Van Dyck's self-portrait. Self-portraiture at the time was a very radical act. It was the 17th century where being an artist was very much a commercial vocation. Van Dyck was very much a celebrity portrait artist. He had people queuing up to buy his paintings because he was so successful. Here, Van Dyck is drawing attention to himself and the role of the artist. Then it was very radical, very uncommon. Whereas if we look at contemporary artists who do self-portraits, such as Tracy Emin, it's very raw, very self-confessional, and often controversial. So it has a completely different aim, where the viewer is invited to judge and, you know, make an assumption on the artist's personality, whereas here, it's more to transcend the status of the artist. We're very used to consuming and projecting images of ourselves, such as on social media. Selfies are obviously very popular, whereas the aim then might be, in a sense, similar to this one, where you're trying to elevate your status.
Portraiture itself had become out of vogue, and self-portraiture even rarer. But Van Dyck transformed it, bringing in a sense of perspectival space, where before the paintings had been flat. He brought in a sense of emotion where before they'd been expressionless, and a sense of movement where before they'd been still and stayed. He conveyed this sense of movement through the posture, which is contrapposto in this painting, which is essentially this. So we feel the movement of him turning his head around as if to greet us as the viewers.
I want to first ask you, what do you think portraiture is? Is it the recording of an individual's appearance and personality? Or does it represent power, importance, virtue and other qualities of the sitter, as seen here by Van Dyck? It's his pose and stature and obviously the frame, which gives off the impression that he's trying to flatter himself. Portraits have almost always been flattering. Contemporary painters who refuse to flatter often find their work frowned upon or simply disregarded due to its controversy. What has sparked many questions in art historian minds are his clothes. Take a glance at the heaviness and roughness of these brushstrokes in comparison to the face, which is smooth and finely detailed. Is this painting simply unfinished, or was Van Dyck experimenting with a new style?
There were no manufactured oil paint at the time. Therefore, him and his assistants would have had to make their own paints from scratch. This would have been done using pigments, such as vermilion red, and oil. This pigment would make ultramarine blue, which is extremely rare and expensive. And therefore, if you can see blue in paintings, here you can see it on the shoulder, it signifies status and wealth. The canvas would have been made with a primer of rabbit skin glue, which, as it may suggest, is made up of rabbit skin. And then the frame, which we've brought here today, which you're all welcome to come and have a look at later, it shows the three stages of its preparation. This would have been the wooden carving, secondly the plaster, and then finished with the gold leaf. Van Dyck's frame was thought to have specifically made for this painting, and that's another thing that you can think about today, is whether the frame that he's chosen adds to the positioning and the composition of the painting.